Good morning and good afternoon, parents. We're so glad to welcome you to our Spring Term Parents Day, even if it is, hopefully for the last time, a virtual gathering. Our teachers at King's Academy are the heart and soul of the school, and the conferences you share today, we hope, are a time when you can connect best with your children's experience living and learning here at King's. The care that teachers bring, their domain expertise, their passion for teaching and learning, and their commitment to high standards are what provide for your children the best preparation for a full and integrated life in the future. I hope today you have a chance to meet with your children's teachers and gather some new insight into King's Academy's rich learning experience. My welcome today to you will be brief. I hope only to highlight a few opportunities coming up and then to share with you a selection of highlights from recent art performances. Normally, we would have the opportunity for a showcase of our community's talents and hard work. So in our virtual setting, we will bring that to you by video for your enjoyment and appreciation. So, three items for you today: a survey, a course selection for next year, and a performance. First, I want to draw your attention to a survey that was announced earlier this week via email. As noted in a message from the communications office, King's Academy is completing its 15th year this year. At this time, we are looking ahead now to the next 15 years and asking how King's Academy can deepen its commitment to our students, to Jordan, and to the world. A survey will be going out to you by email in the next 2 weeks, and it will ask about your priorities and your reflections, your insight into how we can best serve you and our mission, both in the year ahead and in the long-term future when your children are alumni, is essential. We look to you, the parent community, as our first partners. Thank you for taking the time to complete this survey when you receive it. Second, today and in the days ahead, as you're meeting with teachers and thinking about this year, I hope you will also be thinking about what courses might be best for your children for next year. King's Academy's wide range of courses and our flexible graduation requirements allow your children voice and choice in their learning, the opportunity not only to be prepared for university, but also to explore and discover new interests and passions, to deepen their excellence and expertise in some areas within those interests and passions, and then to grow fully together in our classes with students of different ages and backgrounds. I'd like to draw your attention to one particular course opportunity next year. For several years now, King's Academy has pioneered the College Board's AP Seminar course. This is a customized course created here at King's using the College Board's AP Capstone framework. This framework focuses intentionally on essential skills for future success, like critical thinking, collaboration, communication, and creativity. The course teaches students presentation skills, how to manage multiple sources, and more, and prepares students for rigorous and creative study. Next year, this course will be taught by visiting instructor Andy Harcourt, who taught at Deerfield Academy for over three decades. The course will also focus on one of Jordan's most pressing challenges, water. Designed around global water issues and with a focus on Jordan, next year's AP seminar course will be team taught by Mr. Harcourt and one of our teachers here at King's, and it will explore the science, politics, and history of water issues with an aim towards problem solving for the future. I hope you and your children will explore this course as you look at options for next year. Finally, I'd like to close with a celebration of the performing arts. One of our five guiding principles asks us to live an integrated life. When we widen the range of our experience, especially through exploring different means of expression, we develop a richer and more textured understanding of ourselves and others. Please enjoy the following performance from our students in music, dance, and theater, from guitar performances to Shakespearean monologues, from a cello duet to our Arabic music ensemble. Enjoy. Welcome to our Spring Parents Day. We look forward to seeing you on campus, if not today, then soon enough in the spring. Thank you so much. Enjoy.
most stupid quality that has ever existed, if you ask me. It's just these big money corporate companies profiting off naive romantics by selling aphrodisiacs. Like what? Chocolate. Now, chocolate's made of cocoa, and cocoa looks delicious from the outside, but boy, is it disgusting. It's grainy, bitter, just like the L word itself. Riddle me this. Why should an innocent teenager be bombarded with all of this artificial red, pink, sugary sweetness when just going to the store to pick us some Doritos? All I really want is to grab these chips, head to my room, and drown out the yelling from my parents' room with the screams from Chainsaw Massacre II. Believe it or not, that movie is slightly less terrifying than what's going on outside my bedroom door. And the worst part? Everywhere you look has the L word on it. You know the L word? Love? Why should I have to see that word over and over again? Every time I look at it, it feels like a punch right through my gut. And being in a grocery store the day before Valentine's, that L word isn't exactly scarce. Why do I have to suffer through all this? Why do I have to be ambushed by this word at a drugstore when it's a word that my parents don't even say to each other anymore? What is this? I love you very much? Disgusting. Hello? Yeah. Oh, Charlie? Charlie from science, right? I don't have any plans for tomorrow. I know tomorrow's Valentine's Day. Oh, okay. I'll meet you at the movie theater at 7. Who's gonna go? Oh, it's just the two of us? That sounds great. Goodbye. See you then. I mean, Valentine's Day is still stupid. Thank you.
Thank you. Sing along with the